Hi, my name is Deanna Murrell, and I will be doing the financial aid presentation. I'm currently under contract with Riverside City College Student Financial Services Office. We are going to go over what exactly the FAFSA application is, how to apply for financial aid, eligibility requirements, types of financial aid, application timeline, following up with your financial aid office, requirements to maintain your eligibility. What is FAFSA? Well, FAFSA stands for the Free Application for Federal Student Aid. FAFSA is the main application that allows students new and returning to apply for state, federal, institutional, and private aid. How to apply? All students can complete the FAFSA application online at www.fafsa.gov. It's free and easy. You can apply beginning January 1st of each year for the following fall academic term. If you do not have access to the internet or computer, you can apply by phone by speaking to a live person and calling 1-800-433-3243. You can also pick up a paper application from your local financial aid office. Workshops may also be available for you at your local financial aid office that can assist you with completing the FAFSA application online. Eligibility for financial aid. So in order to be eligible for financial aid, you must be a U.S. citizen or an eligible non-citizen, have a valid Social Security number, have a high school diploma or GED, register for selective service if you are a male, and are under the age of 26. Enroll in an eligible program seeking a degree or certificate. So the types of financial aid. There are federal grants. Federal grants include the Pell Grant, and that is free money for college that you do not have to pay back as long as you pass your classes. The Federal Supplemental Educational Opportunity Grant is available to students who have exceptional financial need. Federal Work Study allows students to work a part-time job on or off campus and use the funding to finance your education. State Grants. State grants include the Cal Grant. The Cal Grant is a state grant that is available to students if you have a minimum 2.0 GPA and meet financial and academic requirements. You must complete your FAFSA by March 2nd and have your GPA verified. For more information, you can go to www.calgrants.org. Another state grant is the Chafee Grant, and that's available to foster youth. You must complete the Chafee Grant application and the FAFSA application in order to determine your eligibility for the Chafee Grant. State grants continued. The Board of Governors Fee Waiver, also known as the BOG, it waives the enrollment fees at California Community Colleges. The Child Development Grant is available to students who are interested in working in a licensed daycare facility. Riverside City College Scholarship Programs. Every year, a scholarship application is available, usually during the fall semester, for students to complete and apply for scholarships for the next academic year. Other scholarships and financial aid resources are available throughout the year at the Student Financial Services Office. You may also find additional scholarship resources on our website at www.rcc.edu/student-financial-services. Looking for outside scholarships, you can search at your local library, your high school, your guidance counselor, or career office. Also, local organizations, and possibly your parents' work. In order to apply for a scholarship, you need to write a great personal essay. Get your letters of recommendations early. Make sure you contact your professors, your counselors, people in the community that can write you a letter of recommendation. Beware of scholarship scams. You should never have to pay money to get free money. Student loans. Student loans are federal loans at low interest rates and they must be repaid to the government. For more information, you may visit www.rcc.edu/student-financial-services or www.studentloans.gov. In order to maintain your financial aid, you must be meeting satisfactory academic progress. You must maintain good grades. I can't stress that enough. Federal policy states that students must maintain a 2.0 minimum cumulative GPA, complete 67% of their units known as the pace of progression. W's, F's, and no credits and incompletes affect this. You also cannot have exceeded your maximum time frame, which is 150% of your program of study. Meaning that if your program of study requires 20 units, financial aid will pay you 150% of that program. So we'll pay you 100%, which is 20 units, plus an additional 50%, which is 10 units, will actually allow you 30 units to complete your 20-unit program. After completing your FAFSA, students who plan on attending RCC should check their financial aid online through their RCC student email account and also their web advisor. Once Student Financial Services Office receives your FAFSA, you may be required to submit additional documentation. To view required documents, you may view them on your web advisor. Financial aid tips. You want to make sure that you apply for your financial aid early. Definitely meet the March 2nd deadline. I always encourage students to apply in January. Get a pen and use the FAFSA website. Again, it's www.fafsa.gov. There's other websites out there that will charge you to complete your FAFSA, and you should not have to pay money to get free money. Use estimates if you haven't completed your tax returns or if your parents have not completed their tax returns. Spell your name as it appears on your Social Security card. Be informed, read forms and instructions and brochures. Be organized, start a financial aid file, keep copies of everything. And the reason why we encourage you to keep copies of everything is because the financial aid office may request copies of the documents that you use to fill out your FAFSA application. Be sure to keep your address current with the institution you will be attending. This is especially important if you're eligible for grant money or if you are receiving student loans. So when you get your refund checks, they're not sent to the wrong address. Need additional information? Visit the Student Financial Services Office at any of the Riverside Community College District colleges, Norco College, Moreno Valley College, or Riverside City College. Visit us online at www.rcc.edu/student-financial-services. Our phone number is 951-222-8710. The websites and information that I have provided you with are universal and can be applied to any college or university that you plan on attending. So if you are outside of the Riverside Community College District or plan on attending a college outside of our Riverside Community College District, be sure to follow these steps and follow up with that institution for their guidelines and requirements. Thank you.